Hello everybody and welcome to another video. I just did a video on the receivings of the Russian tandem, which was the first reward for aviation this time around. So if you missed that and you want to see that one instead of this video, you can go check that out. It was released just before this one. But that was the first reward, which you can see here, put on the tech tree. But in this video, we're going to talk about the other reward, the first reward for ground forces, which is the T18E2. It's a United States vehicle, and it slots in very nicely right here at rank 2. Creates no extra gaps as of yet. It's battle rating 3.0 in realistic. How about arcade? 3.0 there as well. And this is fucking amazing. I don't know what else to say. I already explained how much I liked the tandem. I thought it was probably one of the most unique collectible aircraft we've gotten recently. And this thing is also very unique for some of the ground vehicles we've been getting. So the T18E2 is basically an armored car, like more armored than you'd expect a vehicle of this style to be. It's, for starters, it's an 8-wheel vehicle, which is beautiful to see modeled and here in War Thunder. And it actually looks really nice. Seeing it up close, it looks a lot better than I thought it did from the images online. Because on the images online, you see it kind of at like this angle, and it looks kind of ugly. But when we see it in game here, I actually don't think this looks too bad. So it has a 57mm M1 cannon. That's not, you know, that's not like what you'd usually expect on the United States tech tree. It has a grenade launcher, smoke grenades, so that's good. Which look like they're not actually launchers. It looks like they're the things that fall off the back. And it has a 7.62mm machine gun here, it looks like. Or unless this one's the one that's modeled, I can't tell. Now, the history behind this vehicle, or from what I've been told, is that people didn't know if this was going to be on the British tech tree or anything like that, because from what I remember, the vehicle was designed and developed by the United States, but was not used by the United States, and instead was used by the British and such. I don't know if I got any of that information correct. But, guys, there's a very obvious way to tell if it's going to be on what tech tree. Never before in these marathon events, as far as I am concerned, have they given a single nation more than one collectible. And since the British already have the Whirlwind in the event, I wouldn't assume that they would also get a ground vehicle at the same time. Two vehicles for one nation. They always seem to give one vehicle for one nation. You know, each of the four vehicles is for a separate nation. I think it's always been that way. So that's something you can use, a little tip for the future if you're not sure. Like, if you're thinking it's British, British already have one. So, obviously, United States. I'm not going to say whether I agree with this or not. People had this issue with other past vehicles like the Ram and stuff. I didn't give a shit. I really didn't. So, as long as it's in the game, that's good enough for me. Now, whether or not you agree with the fact that this is actually a premium collectible, I personally don't have an issue with this one too much. The T18E2 seems like something a little more unique. It'd be different, you know, there's other T18 variants that they could put on the standard tech tree. The one I simply always had an issue with when it came to armored cars was the M8 Greyhound, because this thing was, like, and I bring this up so many times, one of the most fucking iconic, not only is it iconic, but it was one of the most used armored cars of World War II. It was captured, lend-leased, everywhere. It was used by practically fucking every nation. Practically. I mean, the Germans captured it. I don't know about the Russians, but I know the British had them. Various other of the sub-countries used them. The United States. These things were just produced out the ass. And then it comes to the game, and it's a collectible, and not on the standard tech tree. That's why that one bothered me so much. This one, I feel, is a little more unique and makes more sense as a collectible. But I don't know. You'll have to tell me what you think on that. So, armor-wise, this thing has, for an armored car, it has, let me look, 50 millimeters of armor here. It has 50 millimeters at the front of the turret, whatever this is, and then this bulge in its front. And it has 30 millimeters, sloped, of course. This armor is actually really good for this vehicle. I mean, sure, there's going to be shit that's going to ignore the armor, but that's the case with every tank in the game, practically. This thing has great armor for an armored car. Has 30 millimeters all the way around, 25 millimeters on the anus. Has a little, looks like, door on the back that's only 25 millimeters. Sides of the turret and rear of the turret are 38.1 millimeters. Yeah, this thing's going to be a little trolly, I think, when it comes to the armor. Of course, it's got 5 millimeters of shit, yeah, but who cares about it? Inside, it has 5 crew members, which is great to see. I love having lots of crew members. You've got the driver, the machine gunner, the commander, the gunner, and the loader in the back. And you see all the little bits of ammo and stuff. I mean, look at this engine. Holy shit, it's got propellers. Okay. I mean, propellers. It got fans. What the hell? Look, I've been grinding my ass off. Now, I already explained, I already gave my little mini rant on doing the tasks. The reason it took me so long to get to this was because yesterday, I logged on, I had to sleep, and then I logged on and I said, well, we're going to get these vehicles right away, because that's normally what I do when the tasks come out for the vehicles. I try to get them as soon as possible. But that was before I was stuck for 4 hours not being able to connect to the game because of connection issues. Once I finally got in the game, I had to spend the next few hours grinding. That is why it is now almost 7 in the morning, and I'm only just now doing the videos on the vehicles. Yeah, so apologize about that, though in my defense, it was out of my control. It was up to the servers being shitty. when it came down to this one took longer to do than the air one. The air one was done pretty quickly, but this one I had to grind out the victories. I had to get 10 victories. I couldn't do the 2,000 score because every time I tried, I'd rack up 2,000 score and we'd lose. I'd rack it up with the aircraft and then we'd lose. And it didn't matter. I ended a match with 7 kills at one point and I still didn't have 2,000 score. That's one of my biggest complaints with ground battles. And that match, I also had an assist and a base cap. So I don't like the score system in ground forces because it seems really ass sometimes. When you really need that score, you never get it. Which is shit. So I had to grind out victories, and I think I got 8 victories in a row, and I had already had a victory from earlier, so I was up to 9 out of 10, and all I needed was 1. So of course, the moment I grind out 8 victories in a row and only need 1 more victory, I start losing. That's why it has been taking me so fucking long. I didn't get this task completed until the new event started, the Tunisia event. Then I jumped into the Germans, got right in. The queue was only about 5 seconds long. Everybody was queuing in for both teams, and we kicked ass, and that was it. Let's put it up to 50% here. Now, one last thing I got to talk about is on the Tandem, it only has a single paint scheme, standard green. But on the website, it's portrayed with a silver paint. And I stated that that's must be one of the, since there's going to be special camouflages, quote-unquote unique paints that are going to be given out for each of the vehicles, depending on your progression, that the silver might be the special camouflage, or the chromish look might be the special camouflage for the Tandem that you unlock. So what about this vehicle, if this one's going to be getting one as well? Well, I said they're probably going to do that really annoying thing again, where they give it a winter camouflage, like they did in the past. Or something along those lines. But when I clicked into their camouflages, they've got a whole fucking list of camouflages here, including a winter camouflage. And it looks like they've got access to all of the American camouflages. So that might mean for the very first time, Gaijin is getting off their lazy asses and actually making a unique camouflage. You know, even if it's copy-pasted from a different tech tree, depending on what the paint actually is. Like, if it was a British tricolor paint, I think that would actually be unique in the sense that the Americans don't get access to that paint, period. Otherwise, they could actually just do, you know, what unique is on the tin and give it a unique paint. But we can go ahead and look at it here and all the different paint schemes as we would usually do. So we got tropical here. Very nice looking. I like this paint on pretty much every vehicle. We got the desert khaki, which somebody told me how to pronounce that. I don't know if I'm still pronouncing it right or wrong. Which actually doesn't look too bad in this. I like it on this vehicle as well. Olive sand. Again, doesn't actually look that bad. And this, I think this is another paint I don't really like too much. But like I said in the past, some paints work on some vehicles. And again, this is actually one of the paints I hate the most on the US tech tree. But on an armored car, it actually looks really nice. I don't know how my brain... It's like, what the hell... Okay, this is one I don't really like too much. I'm not sure why. Maybe it's the brown. Just an off brown. Yeah, I'm not a fan of the tricolor anymore for the Americans. It used to be my favorite. I love this bicolor, one of my favorites in the game. Or is it this one or is it the other bicolor? I just like the dark color they give it. Of course, the winter camouflage, which is, well, wintry. And then the new camouflages. Well, this isn't the new one. No, this is the one I like right here with the even darker shade. I love this so much. And then they got a new winter camouflage at some point, which is terrible, but it's here. And there it is. So that's it. So I have no idea what they're going to give it as a special, unless they do that thing they did with the British Armored Car during the Festive Quest. Remember that scammy bullshit where they gave it every single British camouflage, but then removed one of the common camouflages and just re-added it as the quote-unquote unique one? Is there one missing here from this list? Let me know in the comments below. If there isn't, then that means that they're going to be giving this thing something that the Americans just don't get access to normally, which gives me some hope. Just a little hope. But I've already been fucked 2 times in a row on these unique camouflages, so, you know, I've learned my lesson, essentially. But very nice rewards, again. Now, to get this, you got to complete 6 stages during World War II Chronicles currently. 2018's World War II Chronicles Spring event. When you complete 6 stages, this is your reward. For completing 11 stages, I believe, you'll get the Lorraine 155. I don't remember the full name, but that is going to be the next Ground Forces reward, which is a French artillery vehicle with a 155mm howitzer, basically, just a obliterating gun. And a 20mm autocannon, I believe. And for aircraft players, you get a Whirlwind P9, which is the next reward, which is probably the least unique out of the four, considering it's basically just a slightly different version of the Whirlwind we already have in the game. I'm really happy with these event vehicles this time around, personally. I think they're all very, very nice. And the 3 of the 4 are very unique, in my opinion. So yeah. It was completely and totally worth it. So good luck on getting your T18E2. Unless you already have it, then good luck on getting the next vehicles if you are going for them. But I will see you in the next War Thunder video, because I need to... Well, I'd like to say I need to go to sleep, but look at these. I was trying to do these last night. I couldn't do them. So now I gotta do these, because the game hates me.